ZL Entertainment.
Hello?
The most stubborn man I've ever met.
Alice? Alice?
Alan. I'm so afraid. It keeps me in the dark. Please help me. I look at you, Alan, and it's not you. It's something else. Looking out from behind your eyes.
Alice, I'm here.
I'm so alone. It's all gonna go to hell. You need to be careful. Cooperate.
The connection had been terrible, but that wasn't the only thing that hadn't been right with the call. She sounded wrong somehow, but she had called me. I could see a railway bridge up ahead and a warehouse of some sort on the opposite shore. I hoped I could find a car from there. That was pursuing me was growing stronger, and it was taking over everything in its path. As a teenager, just starting to get interested in writing, Stephen King had been a source of inspiration to me. I thought about all the inanimate objects that had come to life in his books. No one is safe in a good horror story, certainly not the protagonist. That's what makes them fun. This was anything but. The darkness could possess anything, and it was getting closer.
Did you call 911? take the facts of our existence for granted, unaware that they are merely a thin veneer of desperate self-delusion covering a vast cosmos of madness and horror. All too often, the stars are right. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode, A Family Occasion. Journalist Alvin Derlis' trip to study the local customs of an insular community in Night Springs has been less than successful. Until tonight.
Well, I'm glad you changed your minds about this. Ancient customs, local mythology. My editor loves this kind of stuff.
Well, Mr. Derlis, we don't want to feel like we're on exhibition. But you have demonstrated the seriousness of your intent.
Oh, I am serious. Really, just do your thing. I'll stay out of your way and observe.
Actually, I thought you could assist us. I'm afraid we are a man short. It would provide you with an intimate perspective.
Could I really?
Of course, Mr. Derlis.
Well, I guess that's the least I... What would I have to do?
Oh, here. Let me show you with a kiss.
I... What did you...
Oh, Mr. Doyle, you have well pleased Nixie Perka, the dweller in flesh. Your body shall host his thousand young, and all shall be glory.
No!
Shh, darling, be calm.
Alvin Derlis learned a harsh lesson. If you go looking for mythology, it may come looking for you. And such quests always bear fruit. In Night Springs.
Thank you.
never been this glad to see the sunrise. I had a couple of hours to get to the coal mine. The coal mine wasn't far now. Today, I would meet the kidnapper, and he would give me Alice. I wouldn't give him any other choice. A drowning man will clutch at a straw. Realizing it, I'd come to believe that the story in the manuscript was coming true. The current of its narrative had taken me deeper and deeper into dark waters. Alice had been taken from me. Barry was probably in jail. I was a fugitive from the FBI. The whole world taken over by the dark presence was trying to destroy me. It all felt real, but it matched a textbook case of insanity.
This is Pat Main, and you're listening to KBF FM. Folks, I want to apologize for kind of abandoning you to that looping music track last night, but I was detained. You see, I encountered a big-shot G-Man with an itchy trigger finger who could use a Well, a lesson in manners and a boot in the ass. Not necessarily in that order either. Now, folks, I know I'm not being very informative here, and I apologize for that. I really should just keep quiet, but I'm just so peeved right now, because some people just shouldn't be carrying badges. I'm just glad that our Sheriff Breaker was there to straighten things out. And if someone I met last night is listening, let me just say, I'm sorry if my mouth got you in trouble. I'm pretty sure you're not the bad guy here. Godspeed, son. I hope you know what you're doing. Now, on a lighter note, I'll be talking to Dr. Nelson all morning. But first, a little music.
Nobody cares about me. Ain't even got a friend. Baby's gone and left me. When will my troubles end? Black night is falling.
Welcome back to KBF FM. Hope you enjoyed that tune. Now, Doc, you were talking about life and finding that special someone, that soulmate.
Well, you were talking about that. I was saying I don't buy it.
Well, see, to me, that's strange, because I always pegged you as a hopeless romantic.
You got me there, Pat. But I think love's where you look for it. And you need to do a lot of looking, sure. But the idea that there's that one special person out there for you, and if you miss that chance, it's gone forever and you're forever incomplete. I mean, isn't that depressing? Or heck, childish even? There's plenty of fish in the sea.
And apparently a fisherman has a fishing analogy for everything, but what you're saying, isn't that a little harsh?
Well, no. What I am saying is that your potential for finding that connection isn't limited to what's essentially a chance encounter. How's that harsh?
Yeah, well, I guess that's a nice thought, but let me say something personal here.
Okay.
Now, well, I don't disagree with you exactly, but I can't really fit that together with what I feel, what I felt for someone, because she was the one, she was. And she, I let her drift away from me. Maybe I didn't put in the work, I don't know, but well, since then, and it was a long time ago, but since then, there hasn't been anyone, not like her. And I'm not saying I dwell on her or haven't moved on. I like my life. I'm not living in the past, but I do miss the way she completed me.
You can't argue with the heart, Pat.
I'm sorry, folks. I had kind of a scary experience last night, and let's just say it's shaken a few things loose.
I was early. I was supposed to meet the kidnapper at noon in the main building. The coal mine was quiet. It was a museum now.
I'm through being jerked around.
Watch!
Alice.
Yeah, I want the manuscript. Don't keep me waiting, Wake.
Hello? Hello! Ah! I'm gonna kill him!
I had to get to Mirror Peak. only way to reach the hillside ahead was to go through the building. I had to find a way to avoid electrocution.
Thank you.
There was no way the flashbang grenades were standard power company equipment.
Them both to silence deep beneath the lake. Now if it's real or just a dream, one mystery remains, for it is said on moonless nights they may still haunt this place.